Okay, the first the topic that we're going to do for today is bonus shares and right shares. It's there in page number, which page number is that?
49.
Any of you have not got the handout? All of you have it? Awesome. It's visible, that portion? Portion is visible, or you want me to? It's okay? It's anyway heading, no? All of you have traced page numbers. Okay, accounting for bonus issue. Anybody can tell me what is bonus shares? Bonus shares. You don't have to read that. Leave that out. It's unzoomed. Yeah. So what do we mean by bonus shares? It's okay, right? Oh man, nice. She said something. Others? Correct only. Yeah, others? She said no, sir. Why are you asking again? All right. Bonus means what, sir? Forget about shares and all. Bonus means what? Extra, right? Extra means always OC. Free, right? So what are we giving as bonus now?
Shares.
So bonus shares means extra shares given to the existing shareholders at free of cost. Three components, correct? What? Again? Come again? What are those three components? Bonus shares are extra shares given to existing shareholders at free of cost. So the company has given some additional shares to the existing shareholders at free of cost, and we have to just do a journal entry for it. Okay? On all the problems, about how many of the problems that you have there, they will just ask you journal entries. They will give you various scenarios where you need to journalize. A very simple and less time consuming topic. After that, maximum what they can ask is balance sheet. Balance sheet is like add-on. They can attach it to any topic that we have in accounts. Okay, so they can attach balance sheet also to this, maybe a full-fledged balance sheet or just an extract, half balance sheet. Ardham bardha balance sheet, we call it as extract. Okay, and we'll see that. We have one such problem, we'll take care of it, what it is. Is it okay? Okay. I hope we are clear with the definition. Everyone? Let's look at a small scenario before we get to the accounting aspect of bonus issue. Let's say A Limited gave 1 lakh equity shares of face value 10 rupees for cash. A Limited gave 1 lakh equity shares of face value 10 rupees for cash. Can you tell me the journal entry for this scenario? No application, allotment, first call, final call, wala drama. All the money we received upfront. Can you tell me the journal entry for that scenario? Sir, yes, sir. Bank account or cash account debit. Okay. Bank account debit to equity share capital. Yes, sir. So we are giving 1 lakh shares. Each ka face value is about 10. It's given at face value, not at premium, but at par itself. So the amount will be bank account debit 10 lakh to equity share capital. 10 lakh, correct? Simple journal entry. From first POC, we've been doing this. Yes or no, guys? Let's relate this scenario to bonus. What is bonus again? Three components. Extra shares given to existing shareholders at free. Last one is what? Free. For bonus also, can I pass the same journal entry? Signal. That is her signal. No, you can't, it seems. Okay, that's her way of saying. It's okay. Others can talk and say. So can I pass the same journal entry for bonus? For bonus also. Example 2, let's say A Limited gave 1 lakh equity shares of face value 10 as bonus. Now can I pass the same journal entry, guys? No. What could be the entry then? Let's split it off. First, what did you debit in that first entry?
Bank.
You debited bank. Can I debit bank?
No.
Can I debit bank?
No.
No, because bonus shares are given at free. But bonus shares is also equity shares only. Once you give equity shares, will the capital be same or it'll increase? So if you give bonus shares, obviously equity share capital will increase. Can I credit equity share capital? Yes. But can I debit a bank? No. So that means credit ka portion you have figured it out. Only debit is missing. Yes. So actual journal entry is reserves account debit to equity share capital. Entry is slightly different, but overall the entry is reserve account debit to equity share capital. The company are going to use their reserves. What do we mean by reserves?
Capital.
No. Profits. Right? Profits. Your P&L account, general reserve like this and all you used to show under reserves and surplus, right? Those reserves are going to be utilized and the company is going to give out bonus through them. Hence, another name for bonus issue is capitalization of profits. In some problems, you will see that they will say past journal entry for capitalization of profit. But what do they mean by that? Past journal entry for bonus. Is that term making sense to you? Capitalization of profit. The profit is getting converted into capital. Hence that name, capitalization of profit. Is this okay? So you have seen the journal entry already. That means we'll skip the topic. 7 questions, same? No. What the? Okay, fine. Any doubts so far, guys? This is not the, you need not copy this. That's fine. Because that's not the journal entry. We'll have to do a small 2 journal entries, in fact. But simplified version of that journal entry are these. Basically, you'll use the reserves to give away the bonus. Okay. Now, what is the next question that will run through your mind? If at all it is running in your mind. Go back to your PUC days or maybe just a little ago. Can you give me some of the examples or components of reserves and surplus? What and all you will show under reserves and surplus? Some components of reserves and surplus. Two we already discussed. What are those? General reserve, P&L account. Only those two, or there could be many others? Huh? Securities premium, and capital reserve, or some, or capital. Capital or capital reserve?
Capital
reserves. Okay, anything else? Statutory reserve, like accounts too, guys. CRR. What does CRR mean? Capital redemption reserves. Basically, the point is you have so many reserves, right? Which reserve to utilize for bonus? Can we use all or is there any restriction? That is the next point. Is it okay? All right. For the purpose of bonus issue, you can use 3 reserves. For the purpose of bonus, you can only touch upon 3 types of reserve. First priority is CRR, capital redemption reserve. All this has been given in your notes and we'll also be doing it. If you still want to copy, you're more than free to do it. Okay. First one is not capital reserve. It is capital redemption reserve. The second priority reserve is SP. SP as in securities premium. Second priority is for SP. Last priority is for free reserves like your general reserve, P&L, etc. Mostly you will see these two as free reserves in your questions. Is it okay? First priority to what I said? Capital redemption reserve. Second priority to SP and the last priority to free reserve. Any questions? No question? Then I have one question. Can you answer? Yes. Is it okay? We can keep it like interactive. That's okay. Why priority? Why should I prioritize for that matter? Everything is shown under reserves and surplus only, no? In balance sheet. Oh, one moment. Sorry. You're getting the question? Everything is, all kind of reserves and surplus are shown under reserves and surplus heading only in the balance sheet. So why should I prioritize or why should I give the bonus in that particular pattern only is the question. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Capitals. So we are providing bonus shares already for existing shareholders. So out of giving CLR out to bonus mm. to existing shareholders.
She mm. internal reconstruction is there in your accounts too. Okay, so she has already attended that. She remembers that. That's very nice, you know. Okay, so she's saying there it comes from. Actually, it is not, but still it's fine. Okay, so it comes from there. So, and she's saying it has to be utilized. Any other explanation? In fact, I've already written. What have I written there? In fact, like, you know, let's modify that. This is a priority, right? 1, 2, 3. Why the priority is, if you create a reserve known as CRR, that is capital redemption reserve, it can be just used for one purpose only. If you have a reserve, these are Companies Act regulations, not accounting standard per se. These are all called out in Companies Act. All right. So like what they say is CRR can be utilized just for one purpose. And that purpose is obviously bonus shares. Since CRR has just one utilization, give first priority to CRR. If you don't have CRR, then what do? Touch the next best reserve, which is what? Securities premium. All of you have read in your foundation or BCom section 52 of Companies Act 2013. Correct. Companies Act says security premium once created can be used for 5 purposes. If you have SP, it can be utilized for 5 purposes. CRR can be utilized only for one purpose. SP has about 5 utilizations. We're going to see that a little later. They are different topics for you. Spread across accounts 1, accounts 2. Okay. So, and lastly, free reserve. Why am I doing free reserve as the last one?
Hello, Chris. The time is 7 a.m.
That's okay. Break time. Sir is saying you should give a break. We'll do it a little. We'll give a break a little later. Why free reserve as the last priority? It can be used for any purpose. There is no restrictions on the free reserve. Hence, last priority has to be given to free reserve. And what do we mean by free reserve? What do we mean by free reserve, guys? What do we mean by free reserve? Gotilva? Freely available. Just go to Banshankri Majestic, wherever you want. Arms will be available. Okay, first priority is we prioritize CRR because it has just one purpose. Next priority, we give it to SP because it has about 5 purposes. And one of the purposes is bonus. Last priority to FR. By FR, we mean the free reserve. Free reserve generally will consist of your GR and P&L. Does not mean only those two are free reserve. By definition, free reserve means any reserve which is available for dividend declaration. Any reserve using which you can pay dividend is known as a free reserve. Definition not as per accounts, as per Companies Act of 2013. All right. All these are called out there. Any reserve using which you can pay dividend is a free reserve. But generally here you will see only two components coming under free reserve. That is what? General reserve and P&L. So far are we good? Can I ask you a question? Is it okay? Suppose they told investment allowance reserve. In the question, you're finding, you're seeing 5 reserves, 5 components. One, you're seeing CRR, SP, GR, P&L, and also last fitting. What is that last fitting? Investment allowance reserve, or for that matter, simply we'll say other reserves. They wrote other reserves as the 5th component. In bracket, they told it is available for dividend declaration. And they close the bracket. It's there in the question. What will you do? You got the question?
Yes.
Right? They wrote other reserve. In bracket, they told it is available for dividend declaration. Now, which all reserves you will utilize for bonus is the question. You tell me. What and all you first you will touch upon which reserve? CRR. Next? SP. And then free reserve in any order. So which are the free reserve in my example that you will use for bonus? General reserve, P&L, and other reserves. Is it okay? So any reserve, if they say is available for dividend declaration, means it will become a free reserve that will also be available for bonus issue. Fine. Yes, sir. All right, sir. Oh, okay. I think this is fine. Can we take up the first question to see the actual journal entry for bonus? You want me to run through the topics that we learnt again? You want to brush up? Okay, maybe once we'll brush up since it's still early morning for a few of us. So we covered what? Bonus shares. Bonus shares means three components. Extra shares given to existing shareholders at free of cost. If these three components are hit, then it is known as bonus, right? All right. So what is the other name for bonus shares? Capitalization of profit, because your P&L account is getting converted into your capital. Hence the name capitalization of profits. By profit, they don't mean only P&L. By profit, they mean reserves in surplus. Is it okay? All right. Now, what are the reserves that we're going to use for bonus? CRR means what? Capital redemption reserve, SP as in securities premium. Lastly, the free reserves. Why we create CRR? I'm sure SP, all of you have heard of securities premium. How does security premium come in? When does it come in? When shares are given at premium. Premium mean anything over and above the face value. The face value is 10 and the shares are given at 15 rupees. At 5 rupees, how 15 minus 10, that is 5 rupees constitutes your premium. That premium is parked in an account known as securities premium. P&L generalism and all, we are comfortable. From the POC, we'll be doing. Yes or no? Only thing which you are not aware of is what? CRR. Why do we create it? What is the intention of it? Is one chapter only we have for that. Okay. Redemption of preference shares. We have two topics, in fact. We have redemption of preference shares as well as buyback of equity shares. There we will cover that, because that will take some time. It's not necessary for this topic. So we will do that. In a week or week's time, we'll be taking up that topic also. Are we fine? Here in the problem, they will be giving CRR. We can utilize CRR for bonus. That's all we need to know for the time being. Are we okay? Am I going fast by any chance? No, sir. Because it'll take me a day or two to get adjusted to your pace. If you feel like, you know, it's a little fast or anything of that sort, please let me know. So far the pace is okay. Everyone, balcony. Okay. Gandhi class also okay, I guess. Okay. All right. We'll start with the questions. It's there in page number 51. We'll start with question number 3. First two also we will do, but we'll start with 3. Can we read the question once? Okay, paid up capital. What's the paid up capital saying there? You can look at the screen projected. That's fine. It's visible for everyone, right? Because I'll make some marks there. So you can, like, you know, kind of pay attention to that. What have I underlined there? Is it rupees 4,500 or just 4,500? That means that is what? The number of equity shares and not the equity share capital. So we have 4,500 equity shares. Each ka face value is about 100. So the total equity share capital is 4.5 lakhs. Okay. We'll see why they've given that. Next, they've given what? Capital reserve, including rupees 40,000 being profit on sale of plant. They will give you 101 types of reserves. But as far as bonus is concerned, what should be our clarity? First priority to CRR, SP, free reserve. Free reserve means general reserve, P&L, and any other reserve out of which we can pay dividend. All right. So here they're giving first reserve is what? Capital reserve. So what should your mind say? Goalie, not required. Unnecessary, it's not relevant for bonus issue is what we are trying to say. Okay. All right. Securities premium is how much? 40. We have CRR for 30, general reserve 1.05, P&L credit. Why is that they've specifically mentioned P&L credit? P&L can also, because the name is not reserves. The name is reserves and surplus. P&L can be a surplus balance also, or it could be also a deficit balance. If you have a loss making company, can they go for bonus? First of all, loss. On top of it, bonus. Possible? No. So if you want to give a bonus, obviously you should be in a profit making zone. Hence, they're specifically saying as P&L credit, because P&L credit indicates profit. P&L debit indicates a loss. So here it's a profit of about 65,000. Any question? Any questions, sir? No, sir. Okay. Investment allowance reserve. It came now. Out of which 5,000 is not available for dividend declaration. How much is total investment allowance reserve? 10,000. Out of 10,000, they're saying 5,000 is not available. That means other 5,000 is available. So that means, can we use it for bonus? Yes. Yes or no, guys? Now tell me, what are the reserves we can use for bonus from this problem? We can use CRR because it is available. And then SP because it is available. Then general reserve, P&L, investment allowance reserve also. These are the 5 you can use for the purpose of bonus. They've not told anything about bonus. Let's read the problem fully. The company wants to give away the bonus at the rate of what?
One share
for every 3 shares held. So they're saying if you have, because bonus are given to existing shareholders, right? So they're saying if the existing shareholder has 3 shares, he will get one as bonus. Fine. And we just need to journalize for this. And we'll start the journal. Guys. Okay. Help me with a question. This is question number 3. What is the ratio they told for bonus? Bonus is given in what scheme? If you have 3 shares, you're going to get 1 as bonus. Yes or no, guys? Now check the question. Do we have just 3 shares in the balance sheet? Do we have 3 shares? Which question I saw? Do we have 3 shares in the balance sheet, guys? How many shares we have? 4,000. We have 4,500 equity shares. Yes or no? Here? Correct? So if you have 3 shares, you're going to get 1 as bonus. If you have 4,500 equity shares, how many bonus shares are you going to get? Is that working okay? Cross multiplication, all of us are comfortable. So X is equal to what now? 4,500 into 1/3, which is 1,500. What is this 1,500? The number of bonus shares or the value of bonus shares? Number. Yes or no? X denote for number of bonus shares, that is X is equal to 1,500. Yes or no? To pass the journal entry, any accounting journal entry, we need the number or the value. We need the number or we need the value. So next we need to find out the worth of the bonus shares. Did they say in the problem bonus shares is worth 50, 80, 90, 120, anything like that? Is there any reference? No. How much was the original share ka face value? 100. So that means bonus shares ka face value also will be 100. How many bonus shares rolled out? 1,500. Each ka value will be? So that means the total worth will be? 1,50,000. We need to pass a journal entry for 1,50,000. Is this okay? You need not do this in the examination. First few problems, we'll be doing it this way. You can show this in your journal entry ka bracket only. You need not put up a separate working note. But we'll do it like this just for simplicity, and it is our first topic. Fair enough? Yes. Now comes the next part, which is what? Which is journal entry. Journal entry in the books of, whose books is this? Have they given the name of the company? No, let's make it as --, or A Limited. Have they given the date of the bonus issue? Sometimes they will give the bonus ka date, 10th April, 15th April, incorporate the date as well. If no date is there, just leave the date as blank. That's fine. All right. Now look at the journal entry. We have not yet discussed this. So look at what I'm writing, and you have to explain me if possible for this. First priority for this, for bonuses. Capital redemption reserve account debit. Okay, how much do we require for the purpose of bonus? Look at the right hand side working note. How much we require? 1,50,000. Go through your question. Do we have 1,50,000 in CRR? How much we have? CRR is not capital reserve, guys. It is capital redemption reserve. Check the question. How much balance we have? Using 30,000, can you pay off 1,50,000? So if you have 30, you can only utilize 30. So CRR account will be debited by 30,000. Because what was the basic funda or basic journal entry for bonus? We saw in the first example. Reserve account debit to equity share capital. Which reserve? According to the availability. Here we have CRR, hence we're going to debit CRR. So far good? Yes. We require 150, we have got 30. We have a shortage or all covered?
Shortage.
So next priority you'll give to what? Securities premium. Check in the problem, do we have securities premium? Securities premium account debit. How much of CRR do we have? 40,000. Any adjustment is there? Not collected in cash, collected in cash, anything like that for securities premium? First problem, no, we can't put every adjustment. So it'll be there. Certain adjustments are there, which we look at it a little later. So CRR account debit, SP account debit. How much have we got it? So how much have we got so far? 70. We required about 150. That means we still have a shortage of about 80,000. Yes or no? For that 80,000, we will use the last reserves, that is free reserve. Okay. Free reserve is your call. You can use it in any order that you want. Is it okay? Do we have enough balance in general reserve? Check. How much we have? 1,05,000. Can we debit off general reserve only? Yeah, any priority. There is no restriction there. So here in this problem, what will I write? General reserve account debit. Or just in one problem, you want to use investment allowance reserve as well? No, this is fine. But we know that investment allowance reserve can also be utilized because it is available for dividend declaration. So this also constitutes a free reserve. Have that in your back of your mind. Fine. So general reserve, how much I need to debit? 80,000. Credit ideally should be given to what? Equity share capital. That's where it differs slightly. You'll give a credit to a dummy known as bonus to equity shareholders account. 1,50,000. Made sense, sir? Bouncer or okay? Actually, credit should have been given to equity share capital, but I gave credit to what account? Bonus to equity shareholders account. We look at the next journal entry also once, and then probably we'll explain. Second journal entry is, actually one moment, hang on. We'll do the narration as well. Being bonus shares given in what ratio was that? At the rate of one share for every three shares held, as per, next wording is important, as per board resolution number ... The key word there is, all other things you can write it in your own words. The key word there is board resolution. All these are companies, right? Can they do the business left, right, center, or is there any protocol they need to follow? They can do it as per their own choice, whims and fancies, or is there any protocol, guys, for companies? That's the companies, right? So before you go for the bonus issue, first you'll have to have a board meeting, and that board meeting you'll pass a, what is, have company law been covered? No. Have you heard in meetings and all, in AGMs, you know, board meetings and all, they pass something known as resolution, right? General resolution, special resolution, board resolution, like this they will say. Anyway, it's there in your Companies Act. They will cover it in detail. All right. That resolution, each resolutions will have a number and it'll also have a date. You need to call out that. It will not be there in your problem. Sometimes they will give the resolution number and the date. If it is there, you need to call out that. Otherwise, you can just say board resolution number ... meaning the number is not known. That is important in your narration. And yes, narration is compulsory for every journal. If you don't, you'll lose a mark or two. have keep in this in your back of your mind. See, institute is quite liberal in deducting the marks. For our sake, you'll be like, yeah, 1 mark will deduct. That's not necessarily so. Like, you know, they're quite liberal. They're a little stingy when it comes to giving away the marks. But when it comes to deduction, it's like, because the level that they're expecting from the CA and the CA students are quite high. The benchmark that they've set up. So we need to match it up. So kindly no mistakes here and all, because this is a simple topic. If it comes, we want to score as much as possible and don't lose out any marks on this. Are we fine with this? That's your narration aspect. Let's look at the second journal entry. Second journal entry is bonus to equity shareholders account debit 150,000. To what? What should have been the actual credit be given to? To equity share capital 150,000. This is your journal entry for bonus. For all the bonus, this is your journal entry. Is it okay? Let's do a quick check. Can you add the two entries? Can you add the two entries for me and see, tell me what is the resultant entry? In first entry, what did I credit? No, credit portion. Bonus to equity shareholders. Second entry, what did I debit? Credit for 1,50,000, debit for 1,50,000. That means they get nullified. Effectively, what is the entry? Reserve account debit to share capital. Because we know that that is the entry for bonus. We pass it like this because it is company, right? The moment they pass the resolution, on that day only can they give off the bonus, or there may be certain time lag. Today they may declare, but they may give the actual bonus share ka certificate after a week or 10 days or anything like that. Yes or no? Since there is a time gap, we record it this way. First one is on the past the resolution on the resolution day, and second one is passed when the actual bonus shares are given. Hence, bonus shares will have two entries. Are we okay with this, guys? For this, probably you can write the narration as being capitalization of profits. If you are a forgetting kind, for the first journal entry in bracket, you can also write what? Investment allowance reserve also could have been used. With that, you can write in your notebook. Just out of curiosity, suppose we want to use all the free reserve available. Can you tell me what will be the first journal entry? Just out of curiosity. I want to use all free reserve. One thought came to your mind. Just like that. Can you tell me the journal entry with the amount? First will be what? CRR account debit? 30. SP account debit? 40. And then? You require how much from free reserve? 80. Yes? 80, you can split it in any way. Maybe 30 you can pick it out from? 30 you can pick from? General reserve. How much of investment allowance reserve is there? 5. 5 you can pick it out from? Investment allowance reserve. Shortage is? 45. That you can pick it out from? P&L. So basically it will be general reserve account debit 30, investment allowance reserve account debit 5, and then P&L account debit 45. You can use them in any proportion. That choice is yours. Alright, here we use general reserve because we were a little lazy. We thought why we'll go green and save a couple of lines. Hence for that we only used off general reserve and finished it there. All of you have copied? Can we start the next question? Any doubts, sir? How is it? We got this long back. Okay. Thank you. Awesome. Can we look at the next question? Second question, we'll take it off now. Okay. This is important. Pay attention to this problem. In fact, this is the one adjustment, one of the major adjustments that they can and they generally ask for bonus has been incorporated here. Check here. Paid up capital, again it is not rupees 80,000, it is just 80,000. So that means this is the number. So we have 80,000 number of equity shares of 7.5 each. In fact, add a few things there of face value 100. Just incorporate this, or rather not 100, of 10 each you make it. Of face value 10 each, called up and paid up. Face value of each share is about 10. But how much has the company asked the shareholders to pay? 7.5. And how much have the shareholders paid? 7.5. Is there any calls in arrears there? Have you heard this term, calls in arrears? Have you? Or we left it in POC only? No, we remember. What do we mean by calls in arrears? Calls in arrears. Call. What do we mean by calls in arrears?
The company is called for money and the shareholders are not paid.
Same. Like our, academy's fees, no.
Yeah.
We keep asking for it, you never pay. Like, you know, let's say the company has asked to pay 1 lakh, but the shareholders only paid about 90,000. Requirement was 1, but the payment was only 90. How much has not been paid? 10,000. That 10,000 we give a fancy name known as calls in arrears. So is there any calls in arrears is what I'm asking. Idhi idrali? Do we have? No. Why? Face value is 10, no? But they've only paid about 7.5. That means 2.5 is calls in arrears, no? It's not called up. That is important there. What word they said there? Called up and paid up. Called means what? How much the company has asked. So company asked for 7.5 and the shareholders have paid 7.5 in the share. So there is no call scenarios in this problem. Are we okay? How did they get the 6 lakh? Can you tell me? 80,000 shares. Each cup called up and paid up value is 7.5. If you multiply that, you're going to get about 6 lakh rupees. True, guys? Alright. Then we have CRR for 1.5. Plant revaluation reserve. What do we do with this now? We got another reserve, plant revaluation reserve. It's another reserve we'll use off. Gotil andre use maabidi. Easy, no? Don't know, use it off. Yeah? Or what do we do? First line, before we started only, what did I say? They may give any number, but our clarity is what? SP, CRR, SP and free reserve. We will include only those reserves as free reserve, which are available for dividend. Anywhere they told plant revaluation reserve is available for dividend. In fact, you cannot use at all. It's backed by accounting standard 10. We have accounting standards here, which will cover revaluation reserve. How to, what's accounting treatment? We can't use it for dividend. Is it okay? So can we use it for bonus, that 20,000 revaluation reserve? Or what are we going to do? Think that it is not there and move on. Okay. Any doubt, guys? No. We have SP. Can we touch SP for bonus? Yes. We have development rebate reserve. What do we do? No extra fitting. Just the reserve. What do we do? We'll strike it off from our notebook only. Easier that way. Yeah. Don't do that at all. Can we use for bonus? No. How about investment allowance reserve?
No.
Hey, last problem we saw. Yes, no. One problem, one treatment you're giving. Huh? Nowhere they have mentioned that it's available for dividend declaration. Hence, we are not going to use this. Fine. General reserve. Yes. And then the company wants to give bonus in particular scheme. That is what? At the rate of 1 share for every 2 shares. In last problem, it was 3:1. Here it is 2:1. That's all extra fitting. I mean, tuck, 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 you'll do off. You'll only do off. Hang on. Don't be so urgent. There is one catch here. The catch is that first line I've written there. The top. What is that top me? Of face value. There is one major conditions for bonus as per Companies Act. I didn't want to say that because I wanted to wait for this problem to come. One of the major criteria. In fact, that is one criteria you have to check in every problem going forward. It was not there. We'll go through the previous problem again and see why I didn't ask you to check that. Okay. That condition is if the company wants to give bonus shares, the shares have to be fully paid up. If any company wants to give bonus shares, one of the major criteria is what? Those shares should be fully paid up. What do I mean by that is? Which question is this, guys? Question number? Second. To give bonus shares, comma, original shares have to be fully paid up. This is the criteria. What do I mean by fully paid up is, it should have reached the face value mark. This also we'll write here only. should have reached face value mark. All these are for your reference only. Don't write all this in examination. They will deduct face value mark and all, brother. They will deduct the marks for you. This is only for your reference so that you'll remember what we did. Okay. So criteria is what? It should have reached the face value mark. What do I mean by that is, look at it here. It's fine. You can write it down. Anyway, we have to write the solution in that page only. If the face value of the share is 10 rupees, the shareholders should have paid 10 rupees. Only then can you pay. Only then can you give away bonus shares. If the face value is 50, the shareholders should have paid 50. Is it okay? Come back to the previous problem. I mean, the problem that we went through just now. Can you tell me the face value of this share? Can you tell me the face value of these equity shares? 10. How much have the shareholders paid? 7.5. Has it reached the face value mark? Not yet. So, as per Companies Act regulations, you cannot. Such companies cannot give bonus shares. That means simple problem. We'll strike off. No. There's another criteria we'll have to do. First, we have to convert that partly paid up shares into fully paid up and then give away the bonus. So, two steps we have to follow in such kind of problem. And these adjustments are tested often in your problem. First kind of are rarely tested. I'll repeat what I just now said. Yeah. To give away the bonus shares, one of the major criteria is what? It should have reached the face value mark. How much ever is the face value of the shares? The shareholders should have paid that much. In this problem, the face value of the share is about 10, but the shareholders have paid only 7.5. You don't go centi and all. So what is shareholders' mistake and all? We asked for 7.5, they paid 7.5. Don't be centi and all here. In fact, we are giving double benefit here, this problem. One, they paid only how much? 7.5. We are converting that 7.5 shares into 10. We are thinking that, what is that 2.5? 10 minus 7.5 is what? 2.5. That is nothing but final call money. We are telling the shareholders, you need not pay. I will think that you have paid. So that 2.5 is one benefit. After giving this, what are we doing again? Giving away bonus. So it's actually, if you see, it is double bonanza. It is not penalizing the shareholders. We are giving away two things. So here, those are two steps or protocols we need to follow. One is to convert and then to give away. Second is to give away the bonus. Can we start the problem? Yeah. We have written one pointer. Maybe we can add another one as well. All these are, in fact, the journal entries and all have been given in your handout, but I'm just writing so that it'll also be there for the relevant question. To convert partly paid up shares, and when I say shares for the bonus, it is always equity shares, not the preference. Bonus shares is given to the equity shareholders. So to convert partly paid up shares into fully paid up, only free reserves are to be utilized. Did you understand? Guys, did you get that? What did I write there? Here, do we have any partly paid up shares, by the way, in this problem? Do we have, or it's fully paid up shares? It's fully paid up or partly paid up? He's saying partly or fully paid up. Can you think why he's saying that? One second. Can you think why he's saying fully paid up? Because his mind is saying company called 7.5. Shareholders paid 7.5. So it is fully paid up. But what did I say? For the purpose of bonus, fully paid up means it should have reached face value mark. Has it reached face value mark? No. That means we call such shares also as partly paid up for the purpose of bonus. So do we have partly paid up shares in this problem? Yes, because the shares have not reached face value mark. Yes or no? So that means first you have to convert that 7.5 shares into 10 rupee shares. For this purpose, you can only touch upon one class of reserve I've written there, which is what? Free reserves. Why, can anyone tell? Companies Act restrictions. For bonus, you can use three reserves. No, what is the first one? CRR. Companies Act does not permit CRR to be used for converting partly paid up shares into fully paid up. And section 52, which regulates SP, also says that you cannot utilize SP for such purposes. Only you can use it for five purposes, nothing other than that. So this, hence SP also we cannot touch upon. That means we are left with only one kind of reserve, which is what? Free reserve. So for the purpose of conversion, we use only free reserve. For the bonus, we use all the three. Are we getting or too much information? Too much information or okay, sir? This will repeat in the next 4 or 5 problems. Same adjustments. Can we do that? All right. So now, have you copied those 2 points?
Yeah.
Journal entries. In whose books have they given the name? Journal entries in the books of? Not given. Unknown limited. So we'll make it U limited this time. Date also they have not given, no? Not given, right? What's the first thing we have to do? What's the first step we need to do? First, we need to convert. That means, can I simply say for purpose of conversion? The purpose of conversion? The first journal entry. What is the face value of the shares here in this problem? 10. Paid up value was 7.5. The difference between the two is how much? 2.5. What is that? That is nothing but the final call money, golden days, first POC. What is the journal entry for final call money due? Final call money due, not paid. Final call money. Equity share, final call account debit to equity share capital. Yes. That's your first journal entry. Equity share final call account debit. How much is the final call money per share? 2.5. And how many shares, equity shares we have in this problem? We have, which problem? Second one, right? How many shares we have? 80,000. So 80,000 into 2.5 will be 2 lakh. Equity share final call account debit to equity share capital. Narration, what you can write? B, equity share final call due. Second, normally in your golden days, what is the second entry you used to pass? First is due. Next is the receipt. Bank account debit to equity share final call. Can I pass that entry here?
No.
Why? They're not anywhere in the problem. They told the company received final call. Normally in accounts, we don't make any assumption towards cash receipts unless they specifically mention. Have they mentioned anywhere in the problem final call money of 2 lakh has been received by the company? No, but in fact, what are we doing here? We're converting that partly paid up shares into fully paid up. So second entry we're going to use is, and for this purpose, we only are going to use what reserve? Free reserve. And what are the free reserves available in this problem? General reserve and general reserve. And what are the components of free reserve? Generally, it is general reserve and P&L. Do we have both or only we have one? Only one. That means we can only use what? General reserve. So if you use general reserve for the purpose of conversion, general reserve balance will be the same or it will reduce. All reserves in surplus will have what balance? Credit balance. How do you reduce it? Debiting. Hence, what should I debit? General reserve account debit. How much will it reduce by?
2 lakh.
Hence, general reserve account debit 2 lakh. Is it okay? 2. Bonus to shareholders account 2 lakh. Check the next entry as well and then ask if you have any doubt. You can write bonus to equity shareholders account or just shareholders account, that is fine. He has a doubt. Checked all the 3 entries. You checked all the three entries there. Now his question is, why is this also a bonus? Are they paying 2 lakhs? No. This we don't call it as bonus shares. Some books refer to this as bonus dividend. Hence the entry, we replicate the same. In fact, you check there, add all the three entries, guys, for me there. Add all the three. First entry, what did you debit? Equity share, final call. Third entry, may you see, what did I credit? Equity share, final call. That means equity share, final call got nullified. In the second entry, may what did I credit? Second entry, may what did I credit? Bonus to shareholders. Third entry, may what did I debit? Bonus to equity share. That means that account also got nullified. So effectively, what is the entry? General reserve account debit to share capital. Just fancy entry, that's all it is. All right? Because this is also considered as a bonus dividend, hence they pass it in a similar fashion. But effectively, the entry is still reserves to share capital. That will not change. Sure, guys? Any doubt here? No. This one, if you have doubt, I can't proceed because all the problems are like this going forward. Matlab, these three entries will come. Seeing stars are okay. Stars are okay. Okay. Fine. Problem is done or still remaining? Only first step is done, which is what? Converting that partly paid up shares into fully paid up. Right? Next, now can we give the bonus? They had paid 7.5 and we converted that 7.5 into 10 rupee share. Now all the shares are fully paid up, meaning they have reached the face value mark. Now the company can roll out what? Now the company can roll out bonus shares. For bonus shares, can you help me? Matlab, you can help me with the same working note. In what scheme are we giving bonus? If you have 2 shares, you're going to get 1 as bonus. Do we have just 2 shares? Check the problem. How many equity shares we have in the problem? So if you have 80,000, how much is the bonus shares? So the number of bonus shares is equal to 80,000 into 1/2, which is 40,000. But to pass the journal entry, we need the worth. So the worth of the bonus shares is equal to, have they told any worth? Bonus shares is worth this much, that much? No, that means what? You can take the worth of the original shares only to be the worth of the bonus shares also. Here, will I multiply by 7.5 or 10? Because the problem says 7.5. Should I multiply by 7.5 or 10? It was 7.5, but for the purpose of bonus, I converted that 7.5 share into 10. So I'll obviously multiply it by what? 10. That means the total worth of bonus is 4 lakh. Fast or okay? The journal. Can you help me with the journal? So what are the things we can utilize? First priority to CRR. Guys, one thing I want to make it clear. No K's and L's in short forms in the examination, please. In your notes, it is absolutely fine. But in examination, no short forms. Here, just to save a little time, we'll be using the short forms. No L's in case. If you want, you can present it like all the amounts are in thousands. And then just write 100. Instead of 1 lakh, you can just write 100. That presentation is acceptable. L's and K's and stuff are not acceptable. They might deduct marks. This is subjective. So please don't do that. Here in class, if you want, you can use. So again, coming back, the journal entry is CRR account debit. Can I use 4 lakh? I require 4 lakh for bonus. Does CRR have 4 lakh? Check. How much we have in CRR? 1.5. That means I can only debit CRR by 1.5. I wanted 4. I got 1.5 from CRR. Next priority to which reserve? SP account debit. Any restriction in SP? Any brackets? They told anything? No. No adjustment. So how much we have in SP? 1.5. That means so far I've got about 3. How much is still remaining? 1 lakh. This 1 lakh here I can only pick it out from one component, that is? Can I write GR? It's fine. General reserve account debit 1 lakh. Credit will be given to a dummy known as bonus to equity share holders account 4 lakh. The key word in the narration is what? All other things are extra fitting. Key component is board resolution number. Okay. It goes without saying, every Now, journal, you have to write a narration. Here, just to save the time, if you want, you can skip it. That's fine. Second journal entry is?
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, is it necessary we have to use CRR, the whole CRR amount, sir?
Sir,
so, we have general results. So we use 2 lakhs there and 1 lakh.
He's saying I don't like wrong numbers. I want like whole numbers. Okay, he's saying I'll use it in any priority. Anyone like to answer that?
CRR is only meant for
He's saying CRR is only meant for that, so use it off. Simple example, you have 500 rupees ka old note. 500 rupees ka old note you have. They told within 2 days, change it, otherwise you can't change. Okay. You have to give now 500 rupees you have to pay somebody. You will use the old note or you will give 100 ka 5 notes. You will give, you have to pay me 500 rupees, sir. You have old note. So old note or 500. You have to pay me 500. Which one you will give? Old note or 100 ka 5 notes you will give? Why? Same logic is saying. This has restriction, no? When there is a restriction, use it off. Because if next, if they want to utilize CRR, company has to again give what? Bonuses. You don't know when they'll come. When that bonus will come. Hence, use off the CRR as and when the conditions apply. Fair enough? Hope we answered. Others also hope have got it. If at all they had that doubt.
Suppose we had general reserve of 2 lakhs. Not 3 lakhs.
General reserve of?
2 lakhs.
Okay. So, how much have we already utilized?
2 lakhs.
Okay. So we have general reserve of
2 lakhs.
So she's saying, you know, only general reserve is 2 lakh. How can we? Don't go for bonus. Bonus, because the very definition of bonus is what? Capitalization of profit. If you don't have profit, can't. Theoretically, no. And they'll not obviously go for it also. Any company rationally also, if you think, if they want to go for bonus, they will have a huge amount of reserves in surplus. Otherwise, they will not even think about bonus and all. First of all, they only don't have money, they'll give extra benefit. Good question, but hope we answered it. Any other questions? Nice, nice, you're thinking. Thinking game is nice. Any other questions, guys? No. Let's write the second journal entry, then we'll ask it out, they're saying. Okay. Second entry is bonus to equity shareholders account debit. ESH stands for equity shareholders account. Okay, to equity share. Capital 4 lakh. So basically in these sort of problem, we need to pass 5 journal entries. 3 journal entries for conversion, 2 for actual bonus. So what is the takeaway of this problem in one line? Can you tell me? When will all the scenario get attracted? When will we do all this? When the shares are, when equity shares are partly paid up. What if preference shares are partly paid up? Just to confuse you, they told. Equity shares face value 10, paid up value 10. Preference shares face value 10, paid up value 8. Then convert that also. Then possible, no? Institute will play mind games like this. I told when it is bonus, it is always equity shares. All other information is goalie. Keep it aside. Fair enough? Okay. So basically this scenario will only get attracted in case of a partly paid up shares. And when I say partly paid up, what do I mean is it has not reached face value mark. Fine. And only in those scenarios, this gets applicable. Anyone has to copy any component? Zoom required? Or it's Zoomer? Yeah, Dopa. Okay.